The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Okay, folks, this is Larry Pesavento setting in for Basil Chapman. Today and tomorrow, I have some good news and I have some bad news. The good news is we're going to have Norm Winsky on at the break. The bad news is you missed Stan Harley of the Stan Harley Stock Market Letter, who was on my show this morning. If you get a chance, go into the archives for today on my show and listen to Stan Harley, because, folks, he is really, really into cycles and done a great job. He was also the 2016 Timer Digest of the Year for stocks, so he does know the stuff. I've known Stan for 40 years, a little longer than I've known Norm. Norm's 30-something years, but it's interesting to take a look. Now, I posted the chart of wheat in here, folks. This is July wheat. And, you know, this is everything you can ask for in technical analysis. You can't ask for any more things than what we've got going on in July wheat right here. Might not work, but this is what it's looking at. That's the 435 level is the level where wheat should be bottoming. You don't have to risk more than about 3 cents there. So it's $150 if you want to be a farmer. But frankly, I think the easiest thing to do is wait till after the crop report that comes out a week from tomorrow. And you're pretty good, a pretty good thing to be going on. Okay, there we. all right, let's take a quick look here. I've had some questions, and the questions. The first question is, what was my single most memorable trading day in all of my years? There's a bunch of them in there. There's about a half a dozen, but hands down, from my perspective, it was in October of 1980. Gold had topped in January of 1980. At the 20th of January, I was liquidating all gold contracts on the 2nd and 3rd of January, because this is what we were looking for to we didn't have to pay taxes on all of our gains for another 18 months, and then you could roll them over into another month, which was, you know, to take care of tax spreads and stuff. So it was really, that's Janet yelling, calling in. She thinks she's got Basil on the phone, but she doesn't know that I'm here today. Anyway, we'll take a look here at what happened. In 1980, the gold had dropped from 800 all the way down to 400 and something, and it had rallied back into October to around $700, right at the 61% retracement. On that Friday, I had sold a huge position in gold, hundreds of contracts, and it closed about $8 in our favor. Going into the weekend, I had I think I had originally a $20 stop, but that Monday morning when I woke up, I lived in Westlake Village, which was about 20 minutes from the office, and I'd get up at 4:45. I would take a shower. I had a little radio in the shower so I could listen to Charles Osgood from CBS News giving the early morning gold fix. They gave a gold fix at that time because we didn't have all the electronic stuff that we have now. We didn't get those computers until 1982, 83. And I turned it on, and I was shaving, and I heard him come on, and he said, "Ladies and gentlemen," he said, "Iranian fighter jets have hit nuclear power plants in Iraq. War has broken out into the Middle East, and the price of gold is soaring." And I have a razor in my hand. I'm shaving, and I don't know whether to slit my throat from the left to the right or right to the left. My heart stopped. And I said, "Oh, dear God." I didn't even stop to finish shaving. I just rinsed myself off, and I turned the radio up a little bit, actually woke the missus up, and she says, "What's wrong?" I said, "Oh, nothing." I said, I just can't hear the radio well enough, so I turned it down, and then he went through all kinds of commercials. And then finally, about 4 or 5 minutes later, by then I had my sweat clothes on. I didn't even bother to put a suit and tie on. And he said, I figured it was going to be my last day at work at Drexel anyway. And he said, "The price of gold is soaring. The London fix is up $2.65. And I thought he was giving me a bad quote. So I got in the car, turned on the radio, and I drove like a bat out of Hades into Beverly Hills. And I got into the office, and I usually got there around 5:30. I got there maybe a few minutes earlier today. I went to the wire operator, and I asked him to give me quotes from London and also from New York. And then I called the New York trading floor. They opened gold at 6 o'clock, and I asked him where gold was trading, and he said it was down about $17. So it was already in the market. Nothing made any difference. I ended up having a great day, but absolutely scared me to death. I was calculating before I knew what the price was, how much I was going to lose. He said the price of gold is soaring. I figured the old limit was $50. An ounce, so maybe two limits. That's $100 an ounce. I was short 200 contracts, so you know that's $2 million right there. And I was trading about 15 million, I think 15 to 20 million at the time. And I'd had a fabulous year. January was by far my best year ever. I've never surpassed 1980. That was one of my biggest years. That was really big. But could you remember, gold was big swings. Anyway, a few years later, I'm on an airplane, and I run into Charles Osgood, and I happened to be sitting about two rows from him, and I walked up to him, and I said, you know, you almost caused me a heart attack. And he looked at me, and he backed off, and he said, oh, he said, I only read that stuff. I don't write it. I said, relax. I said, no, you. This was 1980 in October, and you were talking about the price of gold soaring, and it was up $2.65, and I was short, and $2.65 is a nuisance. And I told him a little bit of the story, and he laughed, and he says, you don't believe. He says, some people come up to me and think I actually make that stuff up, and I said, it wouldn't surprise me. But anyway, that was one of the most memorable. October of 87 was big too, and a couple other days, but that by far was the one that I had me scared the most, because I thought that I had really got myself into a real tizzy. So we want to keep an eye on this. We got the beepers going off. Let's see what's going off now. We got a new high coming up here. New York Stock the Dow Jones E-mini is now back above that trigger price of 206.60. This is, we were expecting it to do this level, so we'll see what's happening. Now, Stan Harley said there was a really strong probability that we made a major bottom yesterday because of the cycles that he was looking at coming in on March 22nd. So whether that's the case or not, I'm not sure, but we'll watch it. We're going to have to take a break here in just a few minutes, and then I'll get back on to some of the other things that I wanted to cover, and then we will move on to a second. Let me just get a second. Hold on 1 second. I'm trying to do two things. I've got to turn this limit minder off. Otherwise, it's going to drive me absolutely nuts. So just give me a second here. 1 second, and we will be ready to go pretty soon, and we'll be going. Oh, we got a call on from Rickard from New York. Are you there, please?
Yes. Hi, Larry. Thank you so much for your work. Just wonder if you could comment or maybe even have some guests on in reference to this time of the year. It seems like March, the market takes a significant dip for people have to sell equities to pay their Uncle Sam or have to pay Donald Trump and Obama for the money they spend. Could you please comment on that or maybe have more guests on that, please?
Yeah, stay with me and I'll cover that at the break.
Yes.
Thank you.
If you're looking to unearth a new financial resource and diversify your financial portfolio, consider the new market-safe core commodity CD from EverBank. This 5-year U.S. dollar-denominated CD gives you exposure to 4 equally weighted commodities, gold, copper, WTI oil, and sugar, in one powerful CD. With no pricing caps, you can potentially earn an unlimited upside payment at maturity if the commodities increase in value across semi-annual pricing dates. And should the opposite occur, your principal is 100% protected. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There's no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on this index CD. Don't miss out. With certain commodities on the rebound, now is the time to take advantage. The March 23rd funding deadline will be here before you know it. So call 1-855-750-4051 or visit everbank.com/TFNN for the CD's term sheet and other important product details and disclosures. Once more, that's 1-855-750-4051 or visit everbank.com/TFNN. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Basil takes your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Okay, we're back, folks. Rick, are you still on the line, please?
Yes, it's Richard, New York, Richard. New Rochelle. Larry, thank you so much for your services. Could you please comment on how CEOs or other individuals may have to be selling at this time of the year, which may trigger the margin calls for the market to take a dip, and it really adds an anomaly that maybe doesn't occur at other times of the year?
It really doesn't have too much effect anymore for several reasons. One, those guys are pretty smart. They have sophisticated accountants. They know how to do covered calls and puts, you know, to protect themselves against, you know, fluctuations like that. And they prorate their taxes. A lot of them are in their own options in the company, so it really doesn't mean a whole lot. Now, if they exercise their options like they're retiring, then that'll mean something. But that has virtually no effect on the market anymore. When you stop and think of how much high-frequency trading and algorithmic trading is going on, that really doesn't affect. Years ago, it did, Richard, but not so much anymore. And most of these guys, you know, we pay quarterly taxes, so it, you know, it really doesn't make any difference whether it's April 1st or October. It doesn't make any difference, really, from my perspective. You know what I'll do is in Phoenix, Arizona, Jim Simmons has a big accounting firm there that does this for the financial industry, and I've known Jim a long time, and I'll have him on as a guest, and maybe he can answer some of these questions for us. But as I recall, the last time we chatted, it really didn't make that much difference anymore.
Okay, wonderful. It just seems like always in March or April, there seems to be a significant dip that recovers very sharply, and it seems like somebody's got to pay Uncle Sam. I mean, you know, how else does he get his money?
Well, this is true. He does have a way of collecting the money. There's no question of that. But I think that dip is related to more of the cycle stuff that we see on a seasonal basis more than anything else. But that's just my opinion, of course.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Larry. Have a good day.
Hey, thanks for calling in, Richard. Okay, folks. Yeah, one of the questions that someone's asked me, by the way, I'm not going to try to do the technical work that Basil does because, you know, he stands alone by the work that he does. And I just want to go through some of the questions that people have asked me. This particular picture that you're seeing here is actually a 4x4 oil painting that is on my office. It was done by Elsie Darnielle way back in 1976 when I first started working at Drexel. I had all these little patterns stuck on little cardboard what do you call those, cork boards, you know, that, and I stuck those on with the little patterns with little stick-it notes. And, well, they weren't even before stick-it notes. They were little little paper clips and little pins, and all these little patterns were there. And then I had all these rules that I had, and this is what I live by. And the first one was from John Hill, that he who knows not what he risks, risks all. In other words, if you don't follow what your risk is, you're risking everything. So if you're not using a stop, you're telling the market that you're smarter than it is, and believe me, that ain't ever going to happen. But the 10 rules that I have here are very, very important. These came basically from the book Reminiscences of a Stock Operator by Jesse Livermore. Also, some of them came out of the Gartley book. But the first one, to me, is one of the most important of all, and that is never add to a losing position. And the reason for that is, you know, you've already made a mistake, and now what you're doing is you're doubling your mistake by increasing more capital, and you should be doing just the opposite. The second one is from W.D. Gann, and that is, when in doubt, get out. You know, having no position is a position, because you're just being patient and waiting for the next trade. Here's one that most people don't do, and they don't even plan their trading, and let alone stick to it. But you need to do that. And number four, thank God, I've always been able to utilize this one. That's take equity out for rainy day periods. And believe me, there are a lot of rainy day periods. It was raining today in Tucson, not because of the market, just because of regular rain. But it's always good to take money out to enjoy your fruits of your labor, and also to help other people, too, if you're able to do that. Number five is one from Amos Hostetter, and that was, never close a trade without a reason. In other words, if you're thinking of getting out of the trade, you must have a logical, you know, reason for getting out of it. Not because you just think it's that that it's a certain price or something. You should have a logical reason, either a market reaction of some kind, or report coming up, something like that. Number six, you know, stops are placed for protection. You have to learn to use them, otherwise you're at the mercy of what the market's going to do. And then, of course, number seven is, the only true facts in commodity trading or Forex trading or any other kind of trading, the only two facts are fear and greed. And that's why being a technician is by far the easiest thing to do, because you're looking at a bar chart. If prices are going up, there's more buyers. If prices are going down, there's more sellers. That's pretty much the bottom line. Number eight is a little more hard to understand. That is, never allow a substantial profit to become a loss. The problem is, what is substantial? You know, substantial for some people might be $200. For other people, it might be $2,000. But, you know, frankly, in my opinion, if you've made over $700 to $1,000, that's your money that you've made. So you certainly don't want to give that back. But if you do, you don't want it to go to a loss, because then that just destroys you. The first mistake teaches, you know, the second mistake kills, and you don't want to go through, you know, that much of a move, because if you're risking $500, you made $7, you now have $1,200 risk exposure, and that's way too much. Number nine comes from one of the old books by my own story by Bernard Baruch. That is, distribute your risk equally over several markets. That goes back to, you know, if you have all your eggs in one basket, you better be sure to watch that basket. And there's nothing wrong with that. If you have one basket, whether it's foreign exchange or grains or meats or gold or silver, whatever it happens to be, if you know that market really well, then that's okay to do that. But if you're just an overall investor, you should probably distribute your capital into bonds and a little bit of real estate and a little bit of, you know, commodities, gold or silver or whatever, you know, distribute it out. But if you're a trader, you can, you know, keep your risks in one basket, but you've got to watch that basket very closely. Number 10 is just like number one, and that is, never hedge a losing position. Because if you hedge a losing position, now you've got a double decision to make. You got the one that you're losing on, plus the position that you put on, and that's usually a bad thing to do. There's an old adage in trading that a hedge is like a stick with poop on both ends. It doesn't make any difference which hand you let go of the stick. You're still holding poop in the other hand. So you don't want to do that. So don't hedge a losing position. Just get out of it. Look at it freely. You know, take a break, and you should be, you know, better off than if you just allow yourself to stay in the market and being hedged. And a lot of times the hedge will work against you. In other words, your long will go down and your short will go up, and that even compounds it. So just remember, that's not a very good thing to do. But this painting was done for me by a very famous artist who her husband was one of my customers, and it's one of my treasures here in the office. Every time I turn around, I look, I see, you know, the days of everybody coming in and out of that office at Drexel and, of course, other places. But that's one of the things that I did, you know, over those past years. So anyway, we're going to be watching the gold today. Made a new high up at that 1250. It did make a 1250, 1.5. We're going to take a little break here. Then we have Norm Winsky from AstroTrend.com coming up next.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Many of our new listeners have heard about the Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive the Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on the Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com.
Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com. This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Okay, we're back, folks. This is Larry Pesavento for Basil Chapman, and I believe we have our good friend Norm Winsky on the line. Norm, are you there?
Yes, sir, Larry. Can you hear me okay?
You're just coming in like you were on a special wave announcement or whatever it happens to be technically. No, we're in good shape. So your charts are going to be posted automatically into the room. So why don't you go ahead and start, and we'll as questions come up, I'll let you know.
Great. I'm going to just focus on a few things. First, though, I want to kind of give the theme is I want to pull up the old Chinese proverb, that catch a fish for a man, he'll eat for a day. Teach a man how to fish, and he'll eat for a lifetime. So that's my theme. I'm going to try to give people some techniques, methods here that hopefully will help them make some money in the future. They can do it on their own, or they can, we'll talk about later how they can contact me and learn more things, you know.
You did.
So anyway, I was on your 9 o'clock show on March the 8th, and we went through some things. So the first few days of March, the last few days of February, I recapped and had some forecasts from that, and also went and talked about some things that had just happened. And, for example, one of the methods I'm going to talk about today is I have several categories of things that I use to forecast the markets. We're going to go quickly through a few of these. And one of them is market math. Gann taught that there's certain numbers that are sort of magical mathematics, you know, magical math numbers. And he likes square numbers. He never mentioned Fibonacci, but that's a whole other story. And I have sometimes Fibonacci numbers pop up. And for example, for the 23rd of February, I had 6,180 days, and that was a turn for the market. And a bigger one was a square number. He liked the square numbers. And so 54 squared, that's 2,916. From the March 6, 2009 low, that was within one day of the high for several of these indices. The March 1, I think, was the high for several of them. You'll see in a minute when we look at some charts. And so forth, right? So another big thing that's happened here in the last few weeks is I do planetary cycles, you know, the astrological things. And one of my top things is when the planets get to, am I getting ahead of myself? Okay, here's a chart here on page 2 now. I'm on page 2. And one of the most powerful things are when the planets get to zero latitude. What is that? Well, the planets are kind of like horses on a carousel. They go around and around, but most people don't realize is they also kind of oscillate up and down as they go around and around. So there's 4 points there as the planets are going up and down. There's the height, there's the peak, there's the bottom, and then it hits the midpoint in the middle there twice, once going up and once going down. And when it hits the midpoint on the way up, that's called zero north latitude. And that seems to be a sensitive point. You can see here on this next chart on page 2, this was my planetary index, sort of my version of the Bradley model. I call it planetary index model. And you can see I was looking for a high right at the end of February there when Mars got to zero north latitude. We'll see in a minute what the next point like that was and if that worked out. So anyway, there we go with that. And then so moving ahead, all this stuff is the stuff I use, most of it, is empirical objective information that you could go look up for yourself. And let's see, now moving ahead here now. It's my big date looking ahead here in March was right around the 17th, plus or minus about a day, when Mercury would reach zero north latitude, the same kind of point, but in the Mercury cycle. And now we know that was an important point for several of these markets.
Norm, we got a question from someone. What do you use for your astrological data? Can you explain to the folks how you get the data?
It gets spit out of my computer programs. The computer program, unfortunately, does not cover everything. I don't think it covers this particular phenomenon I'm talking about now, so I have to go find it on the internet, you know, and print out tables, you know. And then
okay, where do you go on the internet to find astro data? You go to astro.
I just probably Google it like everybody else, you know, and uh-huh. You know you could punch in zero north latitude tables, you know, planetary latitude tables, you know. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I printed out you know like 10 years at a time, and so you know I don't remember where I last got it, you know. So mm-hmm. Sorry about that, but that's the way that's. That's the best I can tell you right now.
Well, Google is a good way, so that's an answer. So go ahead, Mike.
Thank God for Google, right?
Amen.
Google knows everything. Okay, so anyway, so not only are these change in trend points, but they're also polarity points. If you are familiar with the Bradley model, one of the great vulnerable problems with the Bradley model in astrological forecasting is you go along fine and it goes along according to the traditional rules, and all of a sudden, boom, you're upside down. The forecast, the highs are lows, the lows are highs. Everything's up, it's upside down, you know. So I had pretty good success of being able to forecast when the polarity, when the energy is going to flip. And I find that these zero latitude points are one of those points. There's another whole other set of planetary points that we didn't have those prominent in this period of time. We've got several coming up in April. And so we're going to focus on these for right now. So anyway, one of the neat things that happened.
We have a caller from Scott. Are you there?
Yes. The stock is CMEX.
We'll have to cover that at a different time right now, Scott. Maybe at the break we'll pull it up. But we have Norm Winsky on right now discussing his stock market approach. So as soon as we come to the break, I'll post up the CX and we'll take a look at that. But right now we'll let Norm finish. How's that?
Oh, sure. Thank you.
Okay, thanks for calling in, Scott.
All right, so Mr. Gann, as I mentioned, likes the square numbers. He particularly, probably the best, was odd square numbers. So like 7 times 7 is 49. Guess what happened at the highs here on the, when we had made the highs? When was that? The high was back here on the 1st of March, right? And so we hit, the high was 2400.98. Okay, what was that? I was watching for this number because it's 49. That's 7 to the 4th power, or 49 squared is 2401. So that missed by 2 cents. That's pretty good, right? That's good enough for government work, right, Larry?
I think so. 2 cents, you know.
Yeah, another neat mathematical thing that occurred. I thought, well, since we're making new all-time highs, I have a kind of a theory that if you're hitting new all-time highs, you want to go, and if you think that there's a possibility that maybe we're hitting some kind of major generational top, you might want to go back and look at the past, you know, major generational lows. So I got the idea I would play with the low from July the 8th, 1932, at 40.56, and maybe find out some kind of mathematical harmonic off of that low. So I started multiplying, you know, the Fibonacci ratio times that. I did that, I think, about 13 times, and it comes out to about 521. And that's a Lucas number, so you multiply that. And it came out to $21,131, which I think was about $20 of the high when we made our high back in early March, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, on the 1st of March, right? So that was pretty good. And so here's the next one. We just had this. This is amazing. Just a few days ago. Here's your S&P chart here on the screen now.
Oh, hey, we've got to take a little break here, and we'll be right back.
All right.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Okay, folks, this is Larry Pesavento setting in for Basil Chapman, and we have Norm Winsky on the line. Norm, give me 10 seconds to tell the folks that I've posted the chart for CX. That chart came from one of our friends, Scott, that called in, and it's at a 61% retracement on the long-term weekly chart. This stock has tripled since 2016. Scott, I would really raise my stop up on this puppy because it's reached major points. It's a weaker than market stock because it, even though it's tripled in value, it still is still weaker than the rest of the market because it didn't make new highs. So I would either get out of it here and look for a pullback or raise your stop to about $8 a share and let her rip. But that's what it looks like to me. Go ahead, Norm. You've got the floor again and the ceiling too.
Okay, so I was. By the way, all this the information we're on now, page 3, is all from my March letter. Was published back on the 5th of March, so you can see here maybe there's some forecasting methods here that work. Using simple technical analysis, for example, just simple trend lines and channel lines, I got that we could pull back to 23.35. Oh, wait, isn't that near the low yesterday? I think that was about 23.36 and change, so that was pretty good. Now, any of these techniques I just gave you, we reviewed. Could you use those in the last week or two to make some money? Well, let's go ahead and take a look. Just as a side, another mathematical key point I had was March 16th, which was based on the mathematics of music. Pythagoras laid that out, cut back a couple thousand years ago, and all Western music is based on that mathematics, and there's a whole formula for the different intervals in music. And extrapolating that from the October 11th, 2007 high, we get 3,444 days, and that brought you to March the 16th, which you'll see on the chart down here, on the S&P chart down here, 10-minute chart, that we made our high late on the afternoon of the 15th, so it was just a few hours early. And back here, here's the point I mentioned before, March the 1st, there's your high, and that was with Mars at zero north latitude over here. Guess what? This was just within a couple of days at Mercury at zero north latitude also. So that was pretty good. So you could have used these points to extrapolate in the future and make some money. So coming up here now, we have, this is something here, March 22. Oh, that was the low yesterday. There it is, 23.3645 was the low yesterday. So moving on ahead here now, square numbers. Well, look what we have here now. I alerted my folks. Larry, you get my emails there. And yes. I alerted the folks to several days in advance that watch out the NAS. I sort of only watch the NASDAQ casually. I don't, I think the NASDAQ is kind of the, I lived through the internet bubble, and I think of the NASDAQ as kind of the bubble index. You know, then things get, when things get excessive, it's the NASDAQ that's kind of leading the parade, you know, right? And so they have, as you mentioned many times, Larry, they got about five or six stocks the whole party, and you know, and their growth stocks. I don't want growth stocks. I want something. This, to me, the whole business is like having a department store and you have merchandise and you just want to buy low and sell high and move on to the next thing. You know what? You know, when you got something that's in the parabolic mode, you know, it's going up, up, up. You don't know how high is, you know. So, you know, I'd rather just trade something that's kind of in a boring trading range. That's the ideal to me. So, you know, I don't really usually follow the NASDAQ that much, but I keep a kind of casual eye on it. And I noticed that we were getting near a kind of a neat number coming up here back a few days ago, and that we were getting close to that's going to be, 77 square. Well, 77 was a key number for gain anyway. He has this grid he calls the square 9. It's a big mathematical calculator, and this is one of the key numbers on his big grid there. And 77 squared, which Gann would have loved, comes out to 59.29, and the high back there on the 21st, that was Tuesday. Look at that chart there, how the market gapped up. It was like reading Gann, you get the impression that these key points are kind of like a magnetic electromagnetic poles in the time space continuum. And so look, it's like the market had to go there. Look at that, how it gaps up. It stayed there. If you look at the 1 minute bar, I think it took 6 minutes for the top out, and it got within 94 cents, the magic number of 59.29, which is 77 squared, before it dropped like a rock. You see that? So if you think of, you took physics or whatever, a magneto or whatever, it's how electric motor works. It touches the point, and then the electromagnetic pole goes from attraction to repulsion, and then knocks it back the other way, you know. So that's kind of, I think, an amazing thing, the way it gapped up there on the 21st, topped out in about 6 minutes, and then dropped like a rock. We dropped like $100 there, you know. So now I'm going to pull some of these factors all together. Of course, when we're going to talk about corn, what does corn have in common? No, corn has in common that the grains, that's a grain. One of the key two of the key factors for short-term trading corn are the lunar cycle, new moon, full moon, and mercury. Mercury is very important for the grains. And so we had a key moment here just a few days ago where over the past weekend, we had mercury get to zero north latitude. That's a key point in the mercury cycle. And look what happened here with the corn. It made a nice top right there on Sunday night, just as mercury was doing its thing over the weekend there. And right on Sunday night, that's where you had your top in the corn. And now the corn is going down. And it did something really bearish over here, where it took out this hot low back over here, where we had the full moon, right? The full moon was the low, and then we rallied to the mercury zero north latitude, and then we're down, and we took out that low there. And so we were off about, if you did this trade, if you talk about the no, you know, if you want to trade the, if you don't want to use your brains, trade the grains. And look at this. So if you jumped in there just based on the full moon and nothing else, you would have been getting in over here at 369 area, 370, not even 370, under 370. And then it could have gone 2 cents against you for a day. And then before the market even had the regular day session opening on the 14th, because the full moon was on Sunday. And so you would have got in maybe on Monday's opening, and it might have gone 2 cents against you. And then you had a nice rally here from the lows, about 10 cents if you got in early. Maybe you could have made 8 cents until mercury did its thing, and then you could have got out there. It's, you know, it's not too bad, you know. So anyway, that's pretty much pulling it all together. You got your mercury points, your full moon, new moon. Mercury worked for the stock market. It works for the corn. And also on the grains particularly, you have to watch the full moon and new moon too. So that's... Yeah.
I certainly like your comment. If you don't want to use your brains, trade the grains. That's really a good one for two reasons. One, you know, it doesn't have the wild volatility that you get in stock indices and currencies. But as you mentioned, those lunar cycles in the grains are just absolutely amazing. They're within a day. I mean, there's hardly any, you know, stuff. Do we have anything coming in on March 31st to April 1st, that could be really big in the grains, because we have that big crop, you know, planting intentions report, you know, comes in on the 31st of March. We're going to have to take a little break here, you know, to pay a few bills. But when we're off, could you double check your, you know, your astro?
Okay, well, I can tell you right now, there's a new moon on the 27th. And I got a huge convergence. It's not in my notes here, but I have a huge convergence with Jupiter and Pluto. Very unusual there. You know, when I say that, that's something to take notice that geocentric and heliocentric Jupiter, 90 degrees of Pluto, are going to occur within one day of each other on the 29th and 30th of the month. That should be big for the bonds.
Okay, we'll take a break and we'll be right back with Norm Winsky, Astro Trend.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting tfnn.com.
Learn how to trade options with Swim Lessons. Brought to you by TD Ameritrade. Think or swim. Next on TFNN.
Okay, we're back. This is not Basil Chapman. It's Larry Pesavento sitting in for Basil Chapman in our... Okay, this is Larry Pesavento sitting in for Basil Chapman, and I have as my guest today none other than the famous astrologer, financier, raconteur from Naples, Florida, Norm Winsky. Norm, why don't you tell the folks a little bit about some of the free stuff that you have that they really should take advantage of, because it's very, very fairly priced, and I know you offer a money-back guarantee on the free program, but it for people that really want to get started into the astro part, why don't you tell them what you have available for them?
All right, real quick, I'm going to give a quick, because some of your Chapman people may not know me. I got over 50 years experience studying the markets. I started when I was 15 years old. I'm 66 now. During my college days, I was investing and made enough money to, in 1975, buy a membership on the fledgling Chicago Board Options Exchange. A few years later, I was traded also on the Board of Trade, so I have a little bit of a few years of experience. And so, and I've been studying the GAN, Astro, Elliott Wave, all these different methods. There's one thing that ties it all together. They're all rooted in nature, and I believe that there's a lot of intelligence in nature that can beat all these algorithms and computers because they're just trying to emulate what nature does. So here you can learn more about this by contacting me. I have a free, you can get the letter, my letter for free, and I have a free class to go with that individual one-on-one class. Usually lasts about 5 hours. I'm going to give you a cram sort of college course in all these different methods in about 5 hours, and then we're going to follow through and so forth and teach you a whole bunch of stuff, and it's all free. And you can contact me at here in I'm in Naples, Florida, as Larry mentioned, at my phone 239-594-3939, or you can reach me on Skype at norm.winski, and you know, and so forth. And there's my email. Here's the email you want, not the one that's on the website or you probably have there in the den or whatever. That's nwinski@embarkmail.com. nwinski@embarkmail.com. And so there, we're looking forward to helping lots of you, lots of those TFNN people out there. Larry, any questions?
Well, no, but I would want to comment, Norm. You know, you don't take credit for some of these things, but the folks in the den, you know, they've got good memories, and they remember back on May the 19th, 2015, when we had the new moon and Mercury retrograde, you call for the top for the year, which it was. And then this recently, on the, I believe it was the 8th or 9th of March, you came on saying that we were due for a very strong correction, and you've certainly been, you know, spot on with that. So as long as you keep having good recommendations, we'll keep having you on here. But of course, Norm, you realize the first time you're wrong, you'll have to go into the history books and you will not be invited back. So I don't want to add any extra pressure to you, but folks, Norm and I have known each other too long a time, so we probably joke around more than we should. But Norm, we really appreciate you coming on, and I hope the folks do take advantage of learning a little bit about financial astrology, because, Norm, I've always felt that sometime before I go to that big place in the sky, there's going to be a special segment on CNBC or Bloomberg where they're actually talking about financial astrology. I've had that as on my bucket list. I think it'll still happen, but I really believe that it's got a lot of, you know, applicabilities to these markets. Not 100%, of course, but it's still, you know, something that is, you know, really, really important in my opinion.
Okay. But anyway, call and get a hold of me right away, because I'm already working on the April letter, and I am on a monthly work schedule. It takes me a couple of weeks to produce the next month's letter. And so the faster you get a hold of me, you might be first in line for the April letter and April class.
Thanks a lot, buddy. Nice. And listen, have a wonderful day, and we'll talk to you soon, okay?
You too. Take care, Larry. Thanks.
Thank you.
To you and all your folks there. Bye.
Thanks, folks. This is Basil Chapman's show, and he'll be back on Monday. I'll be taking his place tomorrow.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
This is TFNN.